welcome to today's On This Day in Tudor History. I'm Claire Ridgway, a self-confessed Tudor history addict and history author and blogger. And I'm here every day bringing you an event from the Tudor period that matches with the date. So we're going to go back to 1533 today, which is, of course, in the reign of King Henry VIII. On this day in Tudor history, the 4th of July 1533, 30-year-old reformer and theologian John Frith, who hailed from the county of Kent in southern England, was burned at the stake at Smithfield for heresy. Now, Frith had been charged with heresy because of his religious views, which included his belief that Christ's words about the sacrament, when Christ said, "This is my body," were not to be taken literally. And he also believed that purgatory did not exist. So very inflammatory views for the time. Now, Frith was given the chance to recant, to take back what he'd said, but he refused. So perhaps he could have saved himself, but he refused. And he was burned with Andrew Hewet, a young tailor's apprentice who also refused to recant his belief that the sacrament was not really the body of Christ born of the Virgin Mary. John Frith had been educated at Eton College and then at King's College, Cambridge, before being called to Cardinal's College, Oxford, by Cardinal Thomas Wolsey. Now, according to martyrologist John Fox, who gives the sort of life stories of Protestant martyrs in the Tudor period, it was while Frith was at the college there that he was imprisoned, a prison of the college where salt fish lay, for heresy. But he was later released and he fled to Antwerp, which was where reformer and Bible translator William Tyndale was based. While Frith was abroad, he worked on an English translation of Patrick Hamilton's Diverse Fruitful Gatherings of Scripture, and also a Revelation of Antichrist with Martin de Keyser, which was a translation of Martin Luther's work, and the Disputation of Purgatory, which was a work that was to later get him into so much trouble. Frith ended up going back to England in July 1531 and he ended up in the stocks at Reading. So that's not good. That's not good to return to England and end up being put in the stocks. Then Sir Thomas More issued a warrant for his arrest for heresy. And although Frith tried to hide and disguise himself and tried to get back to the coast to flee to Antwerp, he ended up being apprehended in Essex. He was put into prison and it was there that he wrote even more religious works and ones that would be used against him to bring him down for heresy. He also wrote the articles wherefore John Frith died, which he wrote in Newgate, the 23rd day of June, the year of our Lord, 1533. Now, martyrologist John Fox gives an account of Frith's life, examination and martyrdom in real detail in his book, Acts and Monuments of the Christian Church. And I'm just going to share with you a little bit from his account. His account starts with the words, "Amongst all other chances lamentable, there hath been none a great time which seemed unto me more grievous than the lamentable death and cruel handling of John Frith, so learned and excellent a young man, which had so profited in all kind of learning and knowledge that scarcely there was his equal amongst all his companions, and besides withal had such a godliness of life joined with his doctrine that it was hard to judge in whether of them he was more commendable, being great praiseworthy in them both. But as touching his doctrine, by the grace of Christ, we will speak hereafter." And I'll give you a link to read Frith and Hewitt's stories in full, but I'll share an extract about their actual ends, their executions. Wherefore, on the 4th day of July, in the afternoon, he, Hewet, was carried into Smithfield with Frith and there burned. The wind made his death somewhat the longer, which bare away the flame from him unto his fellow that was tied to his back. But God giving him strength, that even as though he'd felt no pain in that long torment, he seemed rather to rejoice for his fellow than to be careful for himself. When they were at the stake, one Dr. Cook, a parson in London, openly admonished all the people that they should in no wise pray for them, no more than they would do for a dog. At which words Frith, smiling, desired the Lord to forgive him. These his words did not a little move the people unto anger, and not without good cause. Thus these two blessed martyrs committed their souls into the hands of God. Chronicler Edward Hall also recorded their ends in his chronicle, although he gives the 22nd of July as their execution date, which is a little bit odd. But he describes Frith as being very well learned, with an excellent goodly wit, who had been imprisoned for making of a book against purgatory. And he writes of how a tailor called William Holt, which outwardly professed much honesty, but inwardly was a very spy and a very betrayer of as many men as he might bring in danger, managed to obtain Frith's work from a friend of Frith and passed on this work to Sir Thomas More, so helping with Frith's downfall. Frith then underwent diverse and sundry examinations and was taken before the consistory in St. Paul's Church, where he was condemned and delivered to the secular authorities to be burned as a heretic. Hall describes Andrew Hewet, who was also executed on this day, as a very simple and utterly unlearned young man, a tailor, which was also betrayed by the aforesaid Holt. And he writes of how he was also accused in the consistory for holding opinion against the sacrament. Hall states that Frith and Hewet were both burnt at one stake together at Smithfield. And he also mentions the Dr. Cook, who was mentioned by John Fox. One Dr. Cook, which was person of Honey Lane, and one that was the master of the temple, willed the people to pray no more for them than they would pray for dogs, at which uncharitable words Frith smiled and prayed God to forgive them, and the people sore grudged at them for so saying. Chronicler and Windsor Herald Charles Risley simply recorded, "This year, in July, on a Friday, one Frith, a serving man, a great clerk in the Greek and Latin tongue, was burnt in Smithfield, and a tailor of London with him, for heresy." Now, Frith's biographer David Daniel writes of how Frith's death caused widespread grief in London and elsewhere in England, and also on the continent. He was mourned as a talented, modest and good young man. His later influence was important, for the articles which he set out shortly before his execution differ little from those adopted by the Reformed Church in the Prayer Book of 1552. So he's a man sort of ahead of his time and a man that people followed. So that's what happened on this day in Tudor history, on this day in 1533, the executions of two men of the Reformed religion, John Frith and Andrew Hewet, who were betrayed and who were handed over to Sir Thomas More, accused of heresy and burnt together at the stake. But I'll give you a link to read more from John Fox's work about their lives, their examinations, their ends as well. Thank you for joining me. I really do appreciate you following me, and I love reading your comments when I get a chance to as well. You can subscribe by clicking around about there. You can hit the bell to be notified as new videos go live. And please do consider giving this video a like. Subscribing and liking videos really does help other people, other Tudor history lovers, to find me and to enjoy these On This Day in Tudor History talks. Thank you for following, and I'll see you tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.